Hello dear student, how are you? What are you doing? Dear student, today I am going to start physical and health education class 12th unit 3rd yoga and lifestyle topic yoga for preventive obesity. So dear student, you know that today there are many people suffering from obesity and you know that what is the reason of the obesity today, our lifestyle, which kinds of food we are taking, and we are living in a sedentary lifestyle. So there are many kinds of reasons for obesity. So in this topic we will read about the yoga for preventive obesity. So how can we prevent this obesity, how can we cure this obesity, we have to read about this topic. So first of all, you have to understand about the what is obesity in detail. So obesity is excess accumulation of fat resulting in increased body weight. In this problem, the excess fat of body get deposit under the skin, especially in areas like abdomen, chest, shoulder, buttocks and legs. So in this area mostly the fat deposited. Symptoms, how can we identify that we are suffering from obesity? Obesity lead to many health problems like loss of physical efficiency, decline in physical personality, feeling tiredness while performing physical activity, cardiac problems, etc. There are many kinds of symptoms we can find out from our body that we can find out the obesity. You can first of all the physical appearance. First of all, we have to understand about the physical appearance. After this, we can identify also like the many physical problems, physical efficiency, decline, physical personality, feeling tiredness, and while performing physical activity, cardiac problems. There are many kinds of symptoms we can find out from our body. So dear student, now we have to read about the causes. So causes, the many causes I have explained. The main causes, the causes of the obesity are wrong dietary habits. Today you know that which kinds of food we are taking. Mostly people today they want to eat which kinds of food? The food dietary habits, many people they eat the mostly like wrappers food, and you can say that many fatty food. So why this the causes of the wrong dietary habits obesity can be in our body. Next, lacks physical activity. Today many people they lacks physical activity, they are not performing any kinds of physical activity. Overeating or eating a lot of fried things. So overeating or eating a lot of fried things. So there are many kinds of the lot of fried things. Drinking alcohol, sedentary lifestyle, hormonal variation like hyperthyroidism, imbalance of physical, mental, emotional, energy, etc. So there are the many kinds of causes for obesity. So we have to prevent, we have to escape all these causes for the preventive these obesity. So yoga can cure these problems by increasing physical activity and controlling glandular functioning, thyroid, pancreatic and digestive problems. The following yogic methods are helpful to cure obesity. So distant by the all healthy habits when we will follow, then we can also prevent to us from the obesity. Now by the yoga, how can we prevent obesity and how can we cure the how can we cure the obesity disease? So first, Vajrasana. So you know that Vajrasana, rock sitting. In this asana, we sit with flexed legs while hands are over knees and back straight, body is resting over the ankles. You can see the picture of the Vajrasana. You can sit like this. The benefit of the Vajrasana: control obesity. So first of all, we can control by this obesity, improve leg muscles and shapen legs. So our legs muscles can be improved and it get the good shape. It is a meditative pose of the perform various pranayam. In this pose, we can also perform the many kinds of the pranayams, cure gastric problems, flat foot and arthritis. So these are the many kinds of benefit. And one more things, that the only this asana we can perform after taking food. So after taking food, we can perform this asana. So there are the many kinds of benefit. There are the written also few benefit of the Vajrasana in Hindi also, like gathiya, pilia, safed wal, kamar dard, sciatica, pet ki gas, पीठ के दर्द, पाचन शक्ति, फेफड़े के रोग, स्मरण शक्ति, ठीक है, मासिक धर्म दोष, हड्डियाँ वज्र समान, अनिद्रा को दूर, मन की एकाग्रता, स्तंभन शक्ति 72,000, नाड़ियाँ सुधारें. तो दीज आर द मैनी काइंड्स ऑफ बेनिफिट बाय दिस वज्रासन. एंड वन थिंग मोर, कंट्राडिक्शन. सो कंट्राडिक्शन मीन्स विच पर्सन कैन नॉट परफॉर्म this asana. So person suffering with chronic joint pain of ankle should not perform this asana. So this is a contradiction for those people. They are suffering from the ankle problem, ankle pain, so they should not perform this asana. Now this one, second, Trikodasana. So Trikodasana, triangular pose. So feet apart, try to touch opposite hand to foot while other hand is raised up to up and look upward. So benefit, you can watch this figure also of the Trikonasana, mainly in morning time, morning assembly, when you are performing yoga, the daily you have uses this asana, perform this asana. So benefit of this asana, reduce obesity. So first of all, it's reduce obesity, improve trunk and legs flexibility, your acidity, neck spondylitis, lordosis and scoliosis. So these all kinds of deformity can cure by this Trikonasana. And contradiction of this asana, which person cannot perform this asana? Person with severe back pain should not perform this asana. So which person is the suffering from the back pain, they have to avoid this asana. Now student, next, for the preventive measures for obesity, Ardha Matasyendrasana. So Ardha Matasyendrasana, you are watching in figure the position of this asana. In crossed leg sitting, one leg is placed over the other so that the foot touches the opposite hip joint, whereas hand support the spine while looking back. So benefit of this asana, control weight and obesity. Second, shapes the body. So we can control weight and obesity and shape the body. We can also get the good shape of the body, improve spinal flexibility, and spinal cord, spinal flexibility can be improved by this asana. Back and abdominal muscles are strengthened and toned up. Our back, abdominal, back muscles are strength, get strength and tone up, it will be the more improvement. Increase the glandular functioning. Our all glands can perform in better condition. It increase the glandular functioning, can be increased by this asana. Cure diabetes and arthritis. We can also cure the disease diabetes, arthritis, kyphosis, lordosis, scoliosis. So there are the many kinds of disease and deformity we can cure by this Ardha Matasyendrasana. And contradiction, who cannot perform this asana? Person with severe back pain, hernia, pile should not do this asana. So for which person is suffering from these all kinds of problem, they should not perform this Ardha Matasyendrasana. Now distant, the next asana for preventive obesity, Halasana, the plow pose. So it's a position you are watching that it's a looking like a plow, looking like. I think that you have seen the plow. The ancient time, the mostly people they are using like this plow for the plowing field. So this pose is like that, halasana. So that's why it's called halasana. From the lying position, start raising the legs so that they touch the surface behind the head. So in this position we can perform the halasana. So benefit of this asana, control obesity. So first of all we can control obesity. Second, back and shoulder muscles are improved. Our back and shoulder muscles can be also improved. Cure gastric and digestive problems. Neck muscles gain strength. Cure back pains. Improve eyesight. By this asana we can also improve our eyesight. And this asana can improve our memory power. And this asana can improve our memory power and eyesight. And one thing more, we can also cure cold cough. By this asana we can also cure. So contradiction for this asana, person suffering with the neck and shoulder pain should not to do. Which person who is suffering from neck and shoulder pain, they should not perform this asana. So this asana for these people's contradiction for these people's only. Now this when there are the many kinds of more asanas we can perform for preventive our obesity, and we can control also our weight. So some other asanas and pranayams for controlling obesities are here. Paschimottanasana. So you are watching that Paschimottanasana. This position, this is a Paschimottanasana, and sitting by this asana we can touch our knees by our forehead. So this is a Paschimottanasana. By this asana we can also prevent our obesity. Next, Bhujangasana. So Bhujangasana is very important for us. The Bhujangasana, in this position you are watching that by this asana we can also prevent obesity and control weight. And except these are many kinds of more benefit of this asana. Now Salvasana, you are watching, this is a Salvasana. Is in this pose we can perform the Salvasana. By this asana, yogasana for the better, it can be the improve our digestion. And one thing more, it's control our weight and prevent from obesity. Yoga mudra, this is the asana for the yoga mudra, and this asana also improve our control our weight and prevent obesity. And with obesity it can also it can improve our concentration power, and it can also remove our stress and tension. So it is a very important yoga mudra we can perform for preventive our obesity and weight control. Next, Kapalbhati pranayam. So Kapalbhati pranayam we can perform for the controlling our weight and obesity. So there are many kinds of benefit of the Kapalbhati written in Hindi. You can see here it's also benefit for our kidney, anidra, gathiya, protects acidity and digestive problem. It can also give the sign of our face. It can also prevent hair falling and getting white, and thyroid, skin problem, diabetes, cancer, depression, allergy, constipation, gastric problem. There are many kinds of problem we are suffering. We can also get the benefit for this Kapalbhati. So we have to perform in daily basis these all kinds of asana we should perform. Who are suffering from obesity or not suffering, we have to perform the every person these all kinds of the asana and pranayam for our good health. And next, Surya Vedan Pranayam. I have already told about the before this PPT. So in this Surya Vedan Pranayam, you have to inhale from the right nostril and exhale also from the right nostril. And continue, we have to do this pranayam 10 to 15 times. And Kapalbhati, you know that we have to forcefully exhale the our breath. So why these all asanas and प्राणायाम भी कैन ऑल्सो प्रिवेंट अस फ्रॉम अवर फ्रॉम मैनी काइंड्स ऑफ डिजीज प्रॉब्लम्स एंड यू बेसिकली आर रीडिंग इन दिस टॉपिक फॉर द प्रिवेंटिव ओबेसिटी एंड कंट्रोलिंग वेट एक्सेप्ट दिस दिस डिजीज वी कैन ऑल्सो गेट बेनिफिट फॉर अदर हेल्थ प्रॉब्लम्स ऑल्सो. सो डियर स्टूडेंट आई थिंक दैट यू हैव अंडरस्टूड हाउ कैन वी प्रिवेंट अवर ओबेसिटी एंड कंट्रोल वेट. सो यू हैव वॉट एवर टॉपिक्स आई एम टीचिंग टू यू प्लीज यू हैव टू कम्प्लीट ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ वर्क एंड कम्प्लीट क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑल्सो. ओके थैंक यू. नाउ वी विल मीट इन नेक्स्ट पीपीटी.